Today, today on the thread, there was a somebody said something about a CBD shop being exempt. I haven't heard anything much about that. Is that correct? That CBD purveyors.
Yeah.
What?
Some, I guess, acting on depends who's advice. Certain acting on my advice will be trading because CBD is a Schedule 4 substance. Whether it's defined as a health supplement, a complementary medicine, or a Schedule 4 medicine, still regulated by the Medicines and Related Substances Act. So, for purposes of this state of disaster, I would then say that they do fit into the essential goods category. Although I must qualify that, and that any interpretation or argument obviously comes with risk. But same as cannabis, so if you look, I mean, I could share a link on here, possibly if I could find it, but maybe some of the guys in the back might be able to pull it up. But in the States, they specifically declared, the States and Canada, that the cannabis businesses were part of the essential goods. So I would say anybody that is lawfully supplying cannabis products in this country, be they CBD or whatever, if they're being done lawfully through clubs, as long as all your ducks are in a row and you've registered with the biz portal and you've got your certificates and you've got the correct permits, which have changed 3 times today.
Wow. Really? Go into that?
I'll share this. Yeah. Really?
The perk, what do you mean?
Mickelson's attorneys are a great firm. They do a lot of cybersecurity work, a lot of compliance stuff. They're really great. If anybody enjoys legal newsletters of guys that are at the forefront of developments, you should subscribe there. So I've followed them for years now, and they alerted me to this via subscription. And then, because it turned out, and it's embarrassing, but as I said, it's in a state of flux. You can imagine being a politician at this time. And I do have massive respect for our politicians and the steps that they've taken. It really is admirable. But a lot more work to do. But anyway, the regulations which were promulgated last night, I did share them on one or two groups, which you guys might have seen, they were put together in haste. So the actual permit that's included there is incomplete. You might have noticed that there's some blank pages. So due to whatever kind of error, the actual text that should be on there wasn't copied over. So if, for example, the permit has to specify which of the 28 categories of essential services your business falls into.
28?
And then there's 28 different categories of services. Only 3 categories of goods, either food, a medicine, or a hygiene product.
Okay. And this is...
And there's 28 different services which are allowed, which support the 3 essential goods.
And...
So they're courier companies that then can only transport those 3 types of goods.
Oh, okay. Because that's on the tip of everyone's tongue.
The military already stepped in, so I do know there's military presence because I was told that through Futurama, who I try to get my pepper gun from, it's now stuck at courier guy in Johannesburg, so it was disclosed as what it is, a self-defense product, and they're not allowing it through because it's not an essential good.
Really?
So, yeah, no, if you click on the Courier Guy website now, and I'll urge people to do it, you'll see a notice that pops up there, and they're telling you that they need a letter from you saying why your goods are essential goods, and then every package must be marked essential, and then obviously the goods, whether it's a medicine, a foodstuff, or a hygiene product.
When you call it a medicine, do you mean a prescription medicine?
No. Like broadly health and medical services, health supplements, a wellness supplement.
Cool.
Well, look, I mean, they haven't said it in those words. It's just they.
Well, look,
supplements,
Ricky, you know what?
Supplements are regulated by the Medicines Act. So many people use them as opposed to using medicines proper from pharmacies. So, I mean, Wellness Warehouse, for instance, are at least trading online. They were going to keep their stores open up until 4 o'clock this afternoon, and they then called an urgent board meeting to decide whether that was responsible to do, instead of just fulfilling via delivery, which is the advice I've been given. So even to certain, even if they're pharmacies, whatever they are, the responsible thing for businesses to do, even if they can't trade, is to not open their retail stores, but to instead step up and put in place one heck of a distribution system, because through the existing couriers, remember, they can only carry three types of parcels, so they themselves will be looking for that business, and you could get your products to consumers very quickly, you know.
Indeed.
Well, if you think of this.
What were you about to say, Joe?
I was just going to say, it took them like 2 days to decide whether we could walk our dogs or not. So I think that when it comes to the finer things like CBD and things like that, it might take them another day or two.
Well, that's all. That's
no, look, I don't, Joe, I don't think that they're concerned about it. To be honest, they don't have the time to figure that out. So if a product, this in my view, again, and I did qualify and say I could be wrong, Jules might back me up here. I've been wrong too many times. But if it's regulated by the Medicines Act, so health supplements are complementary medicines are, I don't see why in a time of crisis. Those are supplements that people use. They're daily supplements. So as long as they're lawful or being distributed through a lawful mechanism, then I would say they have to get to the citizens.
Okay. That's all very interesting. I actually, today, I didn't go into the small print of anything because I'm having a hard time sifting through which documents which. There's so many documents around. And we're on a couple of very, very lively groups, as it were, and conspiracies abound and all sorts of things. Ricky, last week, I don't know whether you tuned in last week, but I asked all of our guests as a parting shot, if you had carte blanche to be the director of your own movie, which conspiracy theory around this would you choose as the screenplay for it?
Does that question depend on whether carte blanche is the producer?
No, not at all. No, this will be an independent thing and we'll get it to the networks later. No, you won't have to write the script for anything like that. You've got carte blanche, matey. You can express yourself whichever way you like. You can even have your own ending.
Okay.
So which conspiracy, because for there are many, I think there's truth to everything I read in some weird form. It's like stranger than fiction.
Absolutely.
Which, what would you pick as the main thread? You know, boy meets girl at a 5G tower or...
yeah, Jules, look, I guess I've seen this all before, you know, whether it's been through one of the movies in the mainstream, whether through countless documentaries I watched at university. So I certainly consider myself a mild to moderate conspiracy theorist, but at this kind of time for me, I've had to make the decision to put all of that aside, you know, and just to be objective. The new laws and regulations are coming out every single day in this country, and that's what I have to focus on. So I'm putting the conspiracy theories aside for now, but I'll still give in my vote, and I would say that they need to make it on the United Nations.
Aha.
I reckon they're involved.
All right, well, funny you should say that. There's a Charles put us onto a documentary called Who Is Who, and it's on YouTube, and it's an expose for an hour about the WHO's handling of the Ebola virus and Chernobyl and how insidiously fucked up and bloated it all is, and they've got blood on their hands, and it's quite shocking to see that as a documentary. It's quite. Did you see it, Joe? I think you did. Didn't I send it home for you to
watch? But I haven't had a chance to watch anything really.
This is a while back. This is like in the last few months, but it's there. And I'm with you there, Ricky. We went to the UN, and it is only 3 weeks ago that we were in the UN. And they played it down all the time. Wash your hands, keep a distance. You can't get it from this, that. They really were. They were deciding only 3 weeks ago whether to call it a pandemic or not. And now look at it. So there's some weird shit going on in that respect. But Ricky, you're absolutely right. Myrtle and I call it doom surfing, and we don't do it anymore. We catch up in the morning and then drop it and get onto something else. And I've read a book since I got back, and it's been cool reading on paper and not a backlit tablet. Do you envisage, Ricky, to have any time for yourself just to not be a lawyer at some point, or is it just totally cooking in your world? He went.
Sorry, George, you just broke up. You know, you broke up. I'm back. Like a Wi-Fi. I'm in a
house
full of wood and lots of granite.
Okay, mate. I'm just asking.
I can hear you.
Stop to be a lawyer. Just stop being a lawyer for a little while. And do you? You might. Is virtual fishing any better than real fishing? Can you virtually fish?
You look. I guess that should be lawful. You see, that's the lawyer in me. But I'm 100 meters from the ocean, so if I had a drone, I don't know. Like, would I still be entitled to fish? So, like, I thought about that. But, yeah, I don't know, hey?
Okay.
I'm encouraging people not to step out and break the law, even if you are permitted to. I mean, as we know now, it's come out that it was covered up in the beginning. Well, no, it's another question, but this virus is airborne, so the risk is far more significant. So I think for me, I'm going to be very responsible, lock myself down. I've got enough walking room outside and already started some cool exercise routines. So yeah, I do see my days calming down a bit from, I would say, I've said Friday midday, so tomorrow midday.
Okay, great.
Because then a lot of the hard graft, I guess, will be out of the way, or particularly for the businesses maybe that acted quickly, you know, a lot of my clients. So I guess I'll still get some other businesses who might then get arrested because they don't have the correct registration and permits. So I would expect a handful of those calls. But yeah, again, largely it's been a massive responsibility. So I'm actually then looking, I've got a few attorneys who I'm going to be speaking to refer some of that work to. I just don't have the capacity to take it on.
Right.
Well, yeah, I'm still taking on work as much as it comes, you know. In a time of crisis like this, you obviously need to suspend your fees or greatly reduce them to any attorneys that are out there listening.
Completely. Well, we're delighted that we got 30 minutes of your time to update us with them, the law and the regulations, how many there are. It'll take us all a bit of time to learn them, but I, for one, am like you. I'm pretty settled in my way. I've been on the same property for 30 years, and here I remain for another 3 weeks. So it's a psychology thing at the moment. We're thinking of all of the staff that we've sent away with as much money as we can give them and airtime, and God knows what. It's like cracking us up which way it could go. Look after yourself and your wife and the dogs and everything else, Ricky, and thanks for the 30 minutes, and I'm sure we'll see each other offline during the course of things. So go well, my friend, and thank you for being on the Hotbox Show once again. Go and get another 8 hours work. Go get another 8 hours working before you go to bed.
Cool, Jules.
All right, man.
Just half an hour for you, though. Anyway, thanks, guys.
Okay,
thank you for being on the show. Stay safe and see you on the other side, eh?
Thanks, Ricky. Cool, man.
Thanks, Ricky. We love you.
Love you guys. One love.